there's the state line. Welcome to the Deep South, rookie. We've got wetlands, the blues, and the American story, not to mention some of the best hunting you'll find anywhere on this earth. But the floods this year have been worse than ever, and our community is at its breaking point. Camp Haven, the summer camp we worked so hard to open last year, is under threat. If there's one thing I've learned living here, it's that Mississippi Acres folk are resilient. We don't need a savior, just a little extra help. And that's where you come in. Looks like the end of the road. I'm so sorry, but I've actually got to run. I've got a pile of papers I need to grade. I'll call you as soon as I've got a signal. Promise. There, finally. I had to add actual cell service to the list of things I miss about Chicago. Sorry that I'm so short on Southern hospitality right now, but we've got a bit of a situation. Steve Ernie from our flood relief committee was out delivering supplies to elders who couldn't evacuate on time. The levee overtopped and his trunk got totally submerged. Everything scattered. He got away safe, but we don't have the funds to let anything go to waste. Can you go take a look? The water should have mostly receded by now. I'll mark the location on your hunter mate. Thank you. Tracking gators, rookie? Want some advice? Hey, I don't want no silent treatment. You've read Camp Haven's handbook, right? Rule number one, our differences are our strengths. There's no shame in trying something new. I'll give you a few pointers. You show me what you can do. It's win-win. First, find where they gather. Following the waterway is a good bet. Just make sure you're packing appropriately. Their skulls are thicker than a Mississippi senator's. Check the Codex field guide if you need help. Aren't in the habit of abandoning their food. Either Steve forgot his dinner, or he was going to deliver this to someone. Well, it doesn't look all that fresh, and I think you've got enough to carry. Leave the gator some supper. Ah! You're almost there. You starting to get goosebumps, or is it just me? The Delta's a weird place. He said he got stuck somewhere over there by those cypress knees. Bingo. Those are the supplies. Got it? Thanks. This is doing us a huge favor. Hey, are the shadows playing tricks, or is that a briefcase I'm seeing on my feed? Let me make a quick call. Hey, Mrs. Tackett. My new counselor's out where Steve dropped the flood supplies, and there's a briefcase hanging from a tree branch. You know if that's... Uh-huh. Yep. Yep. Yes, ma'am. Give me just a sec. She wants to talk to you.
Well, Miss Davis has got you out on a fine excursion this time of night. Betty Tackett here, chairwoman of the Mississippi Delta Big Game Club. I hate to ask, Sugar, but can you grab the briefcase? Steve's a little ornery and he'll pitch a fit if he don't get his papers back.
You'll have to... Well, nothing to it. Hear that, Mrs. Tackett? You are phenomenal. What happened to that rookie kid I got my hunting license with who couldn't hit a broadside shot on a stationary target?
Loud and clear. I'm gonna extend you an invite if you keep that up. I'm down for the count since I broke my neck, but Steve will get you an application. Hell, he owes you.
Let's take that later, why don't we? We gotta let you go, Mrs. Tackett.
All the best now. Don't be a stranger, y'all.
Betty's lovely, but she's as southern as all get out, as they say in these parts, with everything that entails. Any markings on that briefcase? Not that I don't believe it's Steve's, it's just... Outpost not far from here. Can you swing by and drop the briefcase and supplies off there? Maybe get your breath back too. You could just leave the stuff on the table there. I'll let Steve know. Thanks. Oh, Betty again? Can you pull her up on speakerphone?
Hey, Sugar, can I trouble you for a favor? The boys are having a meeting tonight to discuss our flood relief efforts. And it gets real chilly in the evenings this time of year. Well, usually they get a fire going. But right now, there ain't a single log of dry firewood anywhere in the state. And you know we've got elderly members. I believe you'll find a space heater in that outpost where you left the supplies. Could you be a dear and drop it off at our lodge?
I'd hate to think of someone catching hypothermia. By the way, the Big Game Club has been working together with the African American Hunting Club I'm a member of on flood relief efforts. We've, got some history. Not gonna lie, they weren't super enthusiastic about some transplant from Chicago buying up land and opening a summer camp here. Even Betty, and even though I've been coming here since I was little, I get these kids. But we both got our priorities straight. The future of the community is what matters. Speaking of, we haven't had enough hands on deck to tend to everyone's needs up until now. So there are a couple of errands around the reserve that still need doing. I'll let you know if you're near somewhere you can help out. Let's head over to the Big Game Club's lodge. Make sure they get the heater before their meeting later on. meat. Alligators are ambush predators. They'll lie motionless for hours under the water, waiting for the right moment to strike. So wait them out, watch the water, and strike when you see them come up. We didn't hunt gators much but for self-defense when I spent my summers here. My daddy taught me not to aim between the eyes. That'll just have it pitch in a fit. Try to land a shot between the eye and the ear instead. That destroys the brain, kills it quickly.
Thank you.
See the depression on the ground? Looks like they've been basking around here. Try sneaking up on them when they're idle. We didn't hunt gators much but for self-defense when I spent my summers here. My daddy taught me not to aim between the eyes. That'll just have it pitch in a fit. Try to land a shot between the eye and the ear instead. That destroys the brain, kills it quickly. Time I stop calling you rookie now. With a clean harvest like that, you've earned it. Alligators were endangered here in Mississippi in the late 60s. So wildlife officials packed horse trailers with 3,500 juveniles from Louisiana. They drove them to the Mississippi State Fair and handed them out in bags. Can you imagine going to the fair to ride the carousel and shoot tin cans and taking home a baby gator? Sure makes for more of a prize than a goldfish in a bag. Thanks to those efforts, the state population's approaching 40,000 these days. There's some commercial farming, but mostly they're just hunted for sport.